Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can update data using MongoDB and Mongoose. This is a continuation of the previous video, where we simply are using findOne and find to try and fetch data. A link to that video will be in the video description, along with a link to the GitHub repository that contains all of this code. However, if you have your own project or you want to follow along from scratch, you can do that within this video. You just have to make sure that you have an actual way to connect to a Mongo server and similar code to this. With that said, I'm actually going to delete these lines right here because we're no longer trying to find information. We now want to update it. Now we can actually access user schema, so we can await user schema.update. This is going to take in two objects as parameters. The first one will be the different conditions. So if we go back to our actual documents here, we see that username is Joe here. So we can go ahead and write that. Username is Joe. And then the second object in the parameters is going to be what to actually update. So we want to change this where username is now Frank. Now if I save this, we can actually go into our console. And I can run this with node index.js. And we didn't get an error. We do get a warning, which I'll talk about here in a second. But if we go back into Mongo here and we see Joe right here, if I click on find, we now see the username for that exact document is now Frank. So that seemed to work. However, here we see a deprecation warning. That's because the .update method is actually deprecated. This is in favor of updateOne, updateMany, or bulkWrite. And so we can actually change this to updateOne because we're looking to simply update one document. So if I were to save this, and let's say that we want to change Frank back to Joe, we can now run the code again with node index.js. We no longer get the error. And going back into Chrome, we can click on find. And now we see Joe is back there. So if we look inside of our document here, we see that everyone has the same password, which is password 1 exclamation point. I'm actually going to copy that. We can actually change our query here to password for password 1. Then we're going to actually update our password to abc123. So I can save this and I can run it with node index.js. Keep in mind, we're still using update 1. Now we get no errors or warnings. Going back into our actual Chrome here, we can click on find. And we see that only one of them was updated to abc123. The reason for this is when we use update one, like we are right here, it's going to search for the first document that actually passes this condition within this first argument. And then it's going to update that with the actual new properties right here. Now, if I go back into Mongo and I minimize my console, I can click on this pencil right here. And I can actually edit this right here back to password 1 exclamation point. I can then click update. Now they both have password 1 exclamation point. If I were to go back and I were to use update many, this is actually going to update as many as it can find. So if I save this and going into my console, if I run node index.js, we see no errors. And if I go back into Mongo and I click on find, we see now both documents have an updated password of abc123. And so this is one method of how to actually update data within MongoDB.
Thanks for watching this MongoDB tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the WarrenOffKeys Discord, which will be linked in the video description. If you want to learn more about MongoDB, you can consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.